Alrighty, welcome to a new Pioneer video here on ChannelFireball.com. We're playing Arclight Phoenix today. It's a card I've brought back from the graveyard many times. We are playing in Pioneer using Opt, Consider, Chart a Course, and most importantly, pieces of the puzzle to dump tons of cards into your graveyard, play a bunch of spells, get back Phoenix, and then take extra turns with Temporal Trespass and Galvanic Iteration. Red offers a bunch of different removal spells, Lightning Axes and Fiery Impulses and Spike Field Hazards. And of course, Treasure Cruise makes an appearance. Sideboard, you know, has a bunch of reactive cards. Disdainful Stroke, Mystical Dispute, Gust, Abrade. Some young Pyromancers in case people bring in Graveyard Hate. Same with a Chandra and a Red Crackling Drake. And then some Unlicensed Hearses for your own Graveyard Hate. All right, let's get in here and play round one. Do you want to keep this hand? Yeah, I do, because this hand has Ledger Shredders on turns 2 and 3 with some Fiery Impulses. Seems fine to me. Ooh, Spire Bluff Canal. Interesting. I'm still going to play the Spike Field Cave because I think I'm going to want my third land here because I'm going to want to play Shredder plus Impulse on turn 3 here. SPV Mobile App Psymaster is in closed beta right now, but it is, you can sign up for that if you go to storybookbrawl.com, and we're rolling it out soon. They're gonna kill my thing. Yeah, hey, what up, Blue Spike, welcome. Hey, Mola and Squirrel, now you win some, you lose some. Bento Box Out with 57 months, welcome back. All right, let's play this, and let's play Ledger Shredder and then Consider, and then I'm going to discard one of these Temporal Trespass, or sorry, Fiery Impulses. Definitely not discarding Temporal Trespass here. Yeah, there's an SPV board game coming out here at some point. Spells pierce into your graveyard. I actually think no, given that I'm playing as Esper Control. If they don't have a removal spell for this Ledger Shredder, oof, I like that. Hey, what is up, Gabby? Gabby was actually watching Thursday Night Football. She's a big football fan. Who knew? Let's just play this untapped, because I don't think my life total matters a lot here. Ooh, I don't stop in my beginning of combat. That's going to make me misclick. Let's attack. Just do two, and then we'll see what our spell situation looks like here. Nothing. No plays, huh? They're going to play like a Teferi and have me Spell Pierce it? Wow. Putting Spell Pierce on top. Really good play. Really great play. He's still got it. He's still got it. Yeah, I'll take pieces of the puzzle. Michael Kinter, welcome back to 17 months. And then I'll take a nice little Connive here. Don't mind if I do. Let's put Fiery Impulse back. Not only do I get a +1/+1 counter, I think I might just want to hit my next two turns of land drops too. Hey, Corey, what's going on? Oh, doing great, Corey. Krebsy, welcome back to 5 months. Boom, boom. Too bad it's me. A different company is working on the board game version of SBB. So I could Temporal Trespass here, but I think that's a lot worse than just than casting pieces of the puzzle. Because so I'll take Fiery Impulse here. I think I'll play the Spire Bluff Connect, because that's the one that always comes into play tap. And I think I just hit. I mean, I could Fiery Impulse to basically cantrip or to loot, but I don't think that's a good play. Basically, casting Temporal Trespass when all I have is this in play doesn't seem that enticing. All right, now next turn I can maybe cast pieces into Trespass and line up some good stuff. Oh wow, they did not -3 on the Ledger Shredder. Do I think anything needs to be banned in Pioneer? I don't have a strong opinion on that right now. Let's go look for some more pieces of the puzzle. Okay, and so I'm going to try to set up the business next turn. Let's go ahead and tack Teferi here. I'm going to opt because it's going to trigger the Ledger Shredder. And I'm probably going to discard Fiery Impulse again. There's so many Corey Bees. How do you keep track of them all? And then I'm just going to chart a course here. You wouldn't believe what BK calls this card. Oof, unbelievable. Thank God CR's done. You don't have to hear it. Sensor? Sure, I don't really care about that too much. There is a large Ambush Viper behind there. Yes, yes, there is. All right, so they're going to get to draw off Teferi, but I feel like I'm in pretty good shape here. I mean, yeah, they need to deal with the Shredder, but next turn I'll have 7 mana, so I'll get to double Time Walk. Okay, so now they're going to Elspeth or Wandering Emperor my Shredder. Also, I haven't seen a lot of Phoenixes so far, which is kind of unfortunate. They're going to foretell something. Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, well, I guess this works. Iteration. Mm-hmm. Iteration. Oop, now I get 2 iterations. It doesn't actually combine in any, like, busted way or anything. I'll play Riverglide Pathway, and then I'll play Temporal Trespass, Exiling. I have to exile a lot of cards. And now I'm probably going to flashback a Galvanic Iteration before casting my Opt here. Okay. What is this? Behold the Multiverse Well? Sure, but I'm going to still take my turn here. The Burrito Wizard. Hello. Ooh, okay, let's iteration consider, because consider can dump Phoenixes. So I think having double copies is nice. There we go. Yep, graveyard. No, I will not put Treasure Cruise in my graveyard. And then I'm going to... Oh, I drew a Ledger Shredder. Well, let's test Treasure Cruise. I don't have a way to discard Phoenix here, so I've cast my 3 spells, right? I've cast Iteration, consider Treasure Cruise. So let's just go Ledger Shredder, Inspire Bluff, get back Phoenix. So I attack them down to 12, because remember I have another turn after this. Let's just kill Teferi. If I end up, I guess I could hit them, and I don't know. If I end up finding another Trespass, I win very easily. It's not going to do a whole lot here, but let's go Opt. Hey, what up, DC? Put this on top. Let's go Opt, Trigger Shredder. Discard Phoenix. Opt. Sure, I'll put this on top. Now I can, let's see, consider. Okay. I think I was actually going to kill them that turn, because I was going to discard one Phoenix to Lightning Axe and then hard cast another one. We have another turn after this, yes. Generally, against blue, you're going to want some of the counters, and I kind of like Chandra and Young Peasy, because you have a lot of Fiery Impulses and Lightning Axes to take out. Well, when you play against a deck that doesn't do anything, yeah, the deck's going to look pretty good, honestly. This is a new version of the card. It would kill hit Planeswalkers too, but unfortunately Rending Volley does not, so let's... Neither does Fiery Impulse. Sad, really. Do I want Unlicensed Hearst or Thing in the Ice? They're both pretty bad in this matchup. I think I'm just going to play a Hearse. It is actually kind of nice with a Young Pyromancer, because a Hearse can sit and play, get bigger, and then you just play a Pyromancer to activate it. Oh yeah, look, this is nice. This is the kind of hand you want against, like, Rest in Peace or whatever. Whatever graveyard hit, I guess Rest in Peace might not be legal. I don't know what any cards are or aren't legal. Kydrick, welcome. 31 months, welcome back. Hey, Darius. Yeah, things are going great. I don't really see a reason to cast Opt there. Let's just go Pyromancer. Because I don't have a thing to play on turn 3 anyway. I mean, I have Mystical Dispute, I guess. But my plan was to play Ledger Shredder and leave up Dispute slash Opt. Though, let's actually play this. Let's attack first. Is that bad? Maybe that's bad because of Shark Typhoon. Actually, I'm just going to play Young Peasy. So the reason I kind of want to play this is Absorb. Yeah. Absorb's a card in Pioneer. I used to play Blue Eye Control with Absorb and I liked it. But yeah, I think we've gotten a little past that at this point. Hey, what's up, Dylan? Oh, the dog's snoring next to me on the carpet. You love to see it. I mean, at this point, I'm not going to play the Shredder because they could have Supreme Verdict, but I will opt here. Mm-hmm. Unlicensed Hearse. Yeah, you know what? I kind of like that here to eat their Memory Deluge and Absorb and then play this. Send, and if they don't have Wrath, they're just completely dead. If they do have Wrath, then well, we got a game. Hibachi? Nice, Corey. That's a good pickup. Yeah, they've got a Wrath. Oh, they have Wandering Emperor? That's not going to do it. No, sir. Oh, yeah, Old Frame Absorb is really pretty. Old Frame Invasion cards look so good. I'm kind of into play Ledger Shredder now. If they had Supreme Verdict, they would have just cast it last turn. Do, do, do. Oh yeah, I'll discard a Phoenix, sure. I'm gonna put Galvanic Iteration on the bottom. I don't think I'm gonna play. I'm gonna crew this with Ledger Shredder. I don't think I'm going to play another Ledger Shredder. That's just getting greedy. All right, attack the Wandering Emperor, attack my opponent. Attack my opponent, attack my opponent, attack my opponent. No, Corey, you were correct. I said I technically didn't ask if Rest in Peace was legal. I was just like, I don't think it's legal, or I'm not sure if it's legal, but yes, apparently it is legal. Cycle Sensor to find, I suppose, a Supreme Verdict. And no. Ooh, 1-0. Hop back in the queue here. That was fun. Getting to play Phoenix and getting a bunch of cards back is always good times. I would like to play first. Oh, they have a companion. So we're playing it's like red-black, maybe? They have Giganta. Mm-hmm. Sure. Acceptable hand. Once again, I'm faced with the Spike Field Hazard question. This time it's a little less obvious to me, but I'm probably gonna play the Spike Field Hazard anyway. Oh, that's... I moved my cards around and I played possibly the worst land to play. Cool. cool. Well, either way, I'm playing a Ledger Shredder here, so. I don't know that that was MTGO as much as me. I was just fiddling with the cards, and I clicked on the cards, so. Kind of my bad. Opt. Put this on the bottom. Oh, interesting. I am actually going to cast Spikefield Hazard here, funnily enough. I'm just going to discard a Phoenix. I'm going to play a Spikefield Cave. I really wanted to get my Ledger Shredder going here. This actually worked out just fine. If they play a creature... Oh. They're playing something else. Are they playing... I mean, Mono Red with a Tarka's Command, I wouldn't imagine plays Mutavault very often. Yeah, I don't really know what's up. Yeah, it's just playing another Shredderino, and unfortunately, I'm not going to play Lightning Axe here. It's been 3 years since Pioneer was announced. Though it was announced like a long time before it actually started getting played, right? What is going on over there? Sika's Chariot? Okay. Looking for a cantrip over here. Didn't find one. Guess I'm just gonna smash. Yeah, I guess I did play an in-person. The last in-person tournament I played was a Pioneer tournament, sure. That's fair. That's completely fair. My deck's stalling out a little bit here. This is sometimes what happens if you don't draw like pieces of the puzzle. No play Phoenix. You have accurately figured out that I haven't cast Phoenix. So I think I'm actually gonna... Because if I cast Phoenix, they just attack with the Sika's Chariot. That's pretty bad for me. I'd much rather discard Phoenix to the Lightning Axe here, and now I get a bunch of Shredderinos going. I guess I'll discard Impulse. I'm gonna discard Trespass here. I'm gonna keep Consider. And then I'm gonna axe those two. And next turn, I'm gonna hope to draw a spell. The good thing is, I have a decent chance, even if I don't draw a spell, of considering into something Sky Sovereign. Okay, that doesn't kill either of my things. All right, I've got two Phoenixes in the graveyard. If I draw a land, I'm probably gonna have to cast Consider at this point. But I really, if I draw a cheap spell, then I'll feel pretty good about this. So now, I'm gonna consider, hopefully find a spell. Ooh, all right. A lot of outs here to find a third spell. I mean, I have iteration, but if I have to play my land to flash it back, maybe that was actually worth it. I get to see so many cards though. Yeah, I'll put a piece of the puzzle on top. I'm actually fine drawing that one. Okay. And that's one less off lethal. Yeah, that was a bunch of lands in a row, but I get to see so many cards. Maybe it would have been better just to play land, play iteration, have a bunch of looks. Yeah, I actually think that was better. No, like, I could have just had it guaranteed instead of taking a risk. Though, that way... Yeah, I mean, I get less value out of the loots, but that doesn't really matter too much. All right, well, I'm going to put in some gusts. Against a red-green deck, either gust is good. A braid's probably fine. It kills all those big things that you're trying to play. Spell Pierce, despite countering their 4 and 5 mana spells, I don't think is the way I want to go here. And I'm thinking of Fiery Impulses don't look fantastic. Thinking the ice actually looks pretty good. Maybe take out like two Impulses. I'm putting in two Abrades. Yeah, maybe just take out three Impulses because I'm putting in all the Abrades. All right. When I know more about what they've got going on, I want Chandra or Sweltering Suns or something like that. We just moved. We're still in Denver. We just moved to a new place. Who do we got here? A hand that would like Ledger Shredder, but is keepable. Pieces of the puzzle goes kind of hard here. Mm. Is Thing in the Ice better than Smoldering Egg? I think so, yeah. We moved very close, yes. I'm going to play Odawara because drawing Sokenzen makes that easy, but even if I didn't draw Sokenzen, I wouldn't play Hazard, because if I play Hazard turn 1, Odawara turn 2, all I can cast is one of these cantrips. If I play Odawara turn 1, I can cast one, then turn 2 play Hazard, cast another one, and that's just better. Oh, I would not put Ledger Shredder into... Yeah, the water damage wasn't so bad. We were already looking at places. I'm glad that even though they changed clients, they still have the... this didn't work out as well. Because now I can't play puzzle pieces on turn 3, but I think getting a Shredder down and using my mana was good. Even though it's a new client, like when you F8, they still the Dove cards still stop you. Oh, yeah, that place is great. Clothies. All right. We're gonna, I guess, make things a little harder on me here. Okay, I'm just gonna play Hall of Storm Giants. We're gonna take things a little easy here. Honestly, even though this is gonna eat a card every turn, it's gonna drain me for two a turn. That's a little annoying. But I'm gonna be able to, I think, outrace it with pieces here. I don't like Pioneer so far. I mean, I've played a lot of Pioneer overall. I haven't played as much recently, so I'm trying to get back into it. But yeah, I mean, it's fun. It's a good format. Julie has seemed to get herself acquainted in the new place well enough. All right, I'm gonna just kill the Reckless Storm Chaser now. I think my life total is gonna matter a lot, given that I'm getting drained for two every turn. So let's not take three damage for no reason here. Okay, pieces of the puzzle. Mostly bricked. They are gonna take an Arclight Phoenix out here. I'm keeping the hazards because I might be end up in a spot next turn where I just cast double hazard and a cruise, just because I need to bring that Phoenix back before Clothies eats it. Hey, Duggies, I'm doing great. Some haters and doubters said I wasn't gonna stream today, but I don't think BK is still watching. I mean, I have a target for my two spike field hazards. Hey, what's up, BK? 1, 2, 3. Okay, so I have enough to cruise even without using Phoenix. So let's start by doing that. And I want to say I didn't draw anything that's like that much better value. So let's just double spike field hazard the goblin, I guess. Play a braid. What's my favorite magic art piece? I have so many that I really like. Shivan Dragon is great. Juzam is great. Brainstorm. Honestly, I like this lightning axe a lot too. A lot of really cool ones. Stomp. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Good play of my opponent. Stomping before the Clothies trigger. Smart. So is this just green, red, good cards? Kind of seems so. Okay, I'm probably going to need to bring in a few more threats if they have Clothies and Unlicensed Terse. That's kind of a lot of... That's the dog snoring, by the way. That's kind of a lot of hate here. Okay. Hey, what's going on, Andrew? If they don't have another Reckless... Okay, them not having another Reckless or Rending Volley is pretty nice. Oh. The only thing that beats a bad guy playing black-red midrange is a good guy playing red-green slightly bigger midrange. console, you know, Sky Sovereign console flagship, it's your time to shine. Sika's Chariot, get in there. Okay. This costs 11. So if I put these two in the graveyard, that's 4, 9, draw 10. So if I draw a land, I could play it, but I don't have to, like, Lightning Axe ditch all my cards. Let's just wait a bit here. I'm definitely going to hit for 8. And, well, I guess I'm going to kill the reflection, discarding an island is what I'm going to do. And then hit for 9. And then pass. They're going to get to clothies again. But we're going to make a little more progress here. I might go Iteration of Braid. The only problem with Iteration of Braid that makes it... they needed mana. Interesting. That makes it awkward is then I can't re-choose the new mode, so that actually doesn't work that well. What is this that costs 5 mana that they were so excited to play? Sky Sovereign? Okay. Okay, so I just need to make sure that I can... So I have 3 cards, 6 cards, that's 11. Yeah, so I guess I win, right? Now I can actually Iteration of Braid. So if I do that, Iteration of Braid, I'll have five cards. Then I go to... Yeah, so I can go Galvanic Iteration... Destroy target artifact, choose you. Choose you. Blow up that. And then next turn, if I draw land, I can cast Trespass. If I don't, I can just axe, discard whatever it is. Piece of the Pulse doesn't quite do it, actually. It's funny. Do this. I mean, Piece of the Puzzle might actually get me there off of instants and sorceries, but exactly. He's still got it. It's the word on the street, you know. If you were to show up to a local Magic tournament, it might still be a threat. No, I know I can't triple blue off of puzzle. I'm saying it would dump enough cards in my graveyard. Don't worry. I had it all covered. Look, I have the cards for that this deck that I'm playing right here. This is actually just all Phoenix cards. We'll see if I use them at some point here. All right, I would like to play first. Another companion. Another Giganta. Alright, I'll keep this hand and look for a Charter Course here. So I have Ledger Shredder, Lightning Axe, Charter Course as my ways to discard from hand. Overgrown Tomb, Into Distante. I don't really need to keep a land, I don't think. All right, I will... I guess I'll opt first. Almost assuredly going to play a Spikefield Hazard. Oh, I'm going to put this on top. And then pass the turn, and then next turn I'm probably just going to play Shredder and cast Spikefield. Are we playing like Niv-Mizzet or something? Sure. Oh, or I'll just do that. Mm-hmm. All right. That's not ideal, but any thoughts about the Hasbro stock price drop? I didn't know it happened, and I couldn't care even a single bit about it. Discard. And then I guess I'll play Spire Bluff Canal. I assume my Ledger Shredder is going to die here. But next turn, maybe I'll just cast the Phoenix. I don't know. We'll see what they're up to here. Bring to Light for 4. Oh, Valky, sure. Oh, I think I can kill the Phoenix now. Or the Tybalt, rather. That's kind of nice. Put on top and play Lava Glide Pathway. Fiery Impulse, my Ledger Shredder. Spike Field Hazard, Tybalt. Tybalt. All right, what did they exile, by the way, with Tybalt? Chart a Course and a Triumph, sure. I mean, I'm sure they've got more here, like a Wrath or something. Extinction Event. Ugh, that's pretty gross. Okay. Dang. Okay. Extinction Event? Jeez. Any chance I'll be drafting Throne of Eldraine today? Nah. Okay. Okay. Unfortunately, didn't bin any Phoenixes. I need to find some of those stat. I'm running out of threats here. Another Bring to Light? No, Niv-Mizzet. Hitting a Bring to Light, and that's it, and a Dreadbore. There's a Phoenix. What do I want to do here? I have 7 mana. I mean, I can draw a million cards here. Hey, thanks, Lerondir. Snug, discard Phoenix, Fiery Impulse, and I think I'm gonna play Blue Source and play a Shredder, and then hit with my Phoenix. Oh, Leyline Binding. I guess I should have played Attack before playing the Shredder. I didn't really think they could play anything else. They have a lot of exile removal. It was being kind of tough. Okay, they're kind of out of gas. Let's see. I can Flashback Iteration. Oh, I have a lot of red sources. So I can't do that and cast. So I think what I'm going to do is Flashback Galvanic Iteration. Oh, I can do it that way. Cast Temporal Trespass. Okay, so I'm getting 2 turns here. And then I'm going to cast Consider Pieces of the Puzzle in my graveyard. 16 cards left? No, I actually don't think I do. Play Spire Bluff Canal. Take my first turn. cast pieces of the puzzle. Dang, I need that last Phoenix here. I guess I go looking for the Phoenix. I have 9 cards left. Spell Pierce my graveyard, yeah. Lighting my graveyard, yes. There's another iteration, I don't mind that. And then let's go, I have 5 cards, so I go to 3 cards. Well, hold on. If I go to 3 cards left, that limits the amount of turns I can take. So let's actually not do that. Let's play Spire Bluff. Pass the turn. Well, pass the turn to my turn. And then I go iteration. These Sylvan Chariots are actually be a little annoying here, funnily enough. Iteration. So I have no turns floating right now. Temporal Trespass. Okay, so now I have a bunch of turns. Really need to draw that Phoenix earlier, because now I've got these Hall of the Storm Giant here. And I'd actually win without these Caryatids. But I think I don't have enough turns left to win. Really sad. Okay, I'll play this. Oh, actually, let's see. They block there. Oh, I mean, if they have literal nothing, then I can win here. But I need them to have nothing, because I have 1 card left. I can't cast any of the cards in my hand. There's not even casting. I don't think Sakenzin was going to do it, but I mean, if they even have a blocker, I don't know what my last card is, but maybe they tap out for something. It's kind of hard. All their stuff costs 5. Wait, are they playing 6? Bring to light, no. They had 1 too many mana for me to do this. Bring to light for a Sylvan Caryatid. Sad. Then chart a course? Sure. I don't think my top card can do much here. My last card is also Hall of Storm Giants. I didn't have enough mana to activate both the same turn, though. Yeah, you're missing something. The card they cast out, Bring to Light, is free. Alright. Well, that was kind of unfortunate. Let's see. These are cards I think could be good. Impulses and Lightning Axes are generally not. Guess Young Pyromancer's Thing in the Ice is pretty bad. I think Spell Pierce is fine. It's not amazing, but it's fine. It's fine. I don't really want to take out any of the cantrips. Maybe I just run 1 Young Pyro. This deck's very single-minded. Yeah, it is. That was close. If I didn't have to play Odawara, I could also have channeled that at some point. All right. Yeah, I think the thing I could have done differently that game. It actually did end up costing me that I played Ledger's Rider and then the Phoenix came back and attacked instead of leaving up Spell Pierce. But, yeah. Wow, this hand is so close to being great. The problem is if I keep this and I don't draw a land on turn two, it really does nothing. I mean, I guess I'll keep this instead of going to five. I'll put, putting a trespass on the bottom feels kind of bad, but I think it's okay. This is just an Arnold Palmer. Iced tea plus lemonade. Okay. Hope they don't have a way to kill it on turn two. It's kind of annoying that this means they can play Sylvan Caryatid and I can't gust it, which I would normally like to do. But, oh no. My Shredder. Annoying. Okay. Real Sunjoy. Indeed, indeed. Growth Spiral. Mana Confluence? That's a card, I guess. Well, I can't really afford to play this Ledger Shredder. So I guess I'm just hitting for one, being sad. More Growth Spirals, sure. Doesn't really make sense to indeed he is BK. To do anything to that. The Celestis. Okay. Wow, they didn't play anything I could Spell Pierce or Gust besides the Growth Spiral, which I think would have been a mistake too. Yeah, okay, so this deck's just fizzling this game. Wow, they even get to flip their Celestis now, because flip, trigger it, whatever. Because I just can't play a spell here. Am I preparing for a Pioneer event or just having fun? Why not both? I'm going to Abrupt Decay my Ledger Shredder? No, you're going to put Giganta into hand. Okay. There's an island. I'm just gonna pass still. I don't know. It doesn't really. If I play Ledger Shredder here, I feel like it really just doesn't go well. Mm-hmm. Can't Spell Pierce it, of course, because they have 7 mana to my 3. What has to happen for me to win this? It's not really possible, honestly, but. We'll give it the old go, and I mean, I guess I can just let that resolve. I guess I should see. They put it on top. They think Giganta's better than the average card in their deck. Well, I'm not saying they're wrong. Let's actually play this as blue and then play Pieces of the Puzzle. I'm going to put Consider and Galvanic Iteration in hand. Putting a Spell Pierce in hand when I already have a Spell Pierce in hand and they get to see it is not ideal. They're going to presumably play Giganta, and I'm probably just going to cast Consider. They're playing Bring to Light. I don't have the heart to try to fight through Valky here. All right. I was just so far behind in every metric that it just, you know, whatever. That felt like I got robbed a little, but maybe not. Maybe they have enough exile removal that it's good. Feels like a deck that doesn't stop me from just, like, doing my thing is probably going to have a hard time, but... Ooh, what do we think about this? If I find Pieces of the Puzzle, I'm happy. I'm trying to think, what cards could I consider into that I'd be happy with? I'd be moderately happy with Ledger Shredder, but I think overall this is a mulligan. Yeah, this is a lot better. Keep putting Temporal Trespass back. Just play Spider Bluff on turn one in case I need to impulse something on turn one. Oh, I'm aware that Gus can target Valky. I appreciate you telling me that my cards do, though. Oh, got a little punished. That's like the only draw that really does that, but it does punish me. Because I thought I wanted to leave up Fiery Impulse if they were like playing Mono Red and they play something on turn one. Okay, is this Blue White or Spirits? Yeah, I kind of felt like it was Spirits. This is going to be... I think this is going to go fairly well for me. Let's start with Consider. I think that's fine. Oh yeah, I'll definitely put that in my graveyard. Ooh, an Opt. Let's Fiery Impulse this. I think it's better just to kill things right away in general. Hey, JS2, how's it going? And then now if they play something, there's a pretty good chance I'm just going to go Humph. We'll see. No plays. I'm just going to play another blue source. I feel like this deck wants like 15 blue sources and playing like two red sources. No reason to play anything here, I don't think. Breezy Bee. That's kind of annoying. I could iteration opt here, or I could not. Now I'm just going to cast Arclight Phoenix, because if they spell Queller this, I don't really care too much. Yeah, sure. I think I'm going to play Odawara. I don't think it's that likely that I channel it here. Thing is, if I didn't play into Spellcaller, they would just play Borrower, so I think I kind of had to play that. What I really would like to draw now is a red removal spell. Now I could actually be getting punished a little bit here for playing this up. Ooh, okay. Combat Research, so it's Curiosity. Could have playing this on blue, because if I draw a red spell, I might want to iteration into that. Okay, I guess I need to draw some stuff soon, huh? Well, I mean, they're nice and tapped out, at least. Oh, they were. Interesting. So I could play pieces of the puzzle, just gets countered. I think I'm going to play Thing in the Ice, because I think that that my most likely way to win here is Thing in the Ice. Then I'm going to play this, and they're going to counter it, presumably, with Mausoleum Wanderer, but piece of the puzzle is going to get eaten by Mausoleum Wanderer no matter what, so I think it's good just to get rid of that, and then next turn, hopefully, chain some opts here. Oh, yeah, losing iteration is a big game for sure. Okay. Ooh. Don't think that was the play. Because they drew a card off Spectral Sailor, but yes, if they drew another Supreme Phantom, they'd hit for 3 more damage, but they're drawing a card off Combat Research. Imagine if they drew a Spell Queller off Combat Research and now they can't cast it. That could be kind of bad for them. Top. Okay, so now I'm going to go iteration. Go to 7. Chart a course. Yoink. Yeah, I'll cast a Phoenix. Why not? Draw 2. Discard Treasure Cruise at this point. Draw 2. Discard Spell Pierce. Yeah, I'll cast... Oh, wait, I guess I already played a land. I was going to say I'll play a land, but... 7? They're 20. I think I'm going to win next turn by a lot, so let's just leave Phoenix back. I don't really... Because they have Spectral Sailor. They have F6. They could have just cast their Spectral Sailor. I mean, they're pretty dead either way. Did I ever play Netrunner? I didn't play either version. I was aware of both of them, but I never actually played them. Supreme Phantom, go. One, two, three, four, six, seven. Mm-hmm. Yep, Spell Queller. Guess I'll consider then. Oh. Alright, and then I'm gonna hit with Woken Horror and Phoenix. No, I guess just Woken Horror. Oh, I actually should I should have just played Temporal Trespass, I think. It's probably a little greedy to play the pieces of the puzzle. I think we're gonna be fine here, but there wasn't really a reason to do that. Hey, what's up, Sims? Because finding Fiery Impulse means I'm gonna get to Fiery Impulse the Supreme Phantom. And then I'm gonna Spike Field Hazard the Spectral Sailor. And pass the turn. Why are we playing one of the Guru lands? I thought that MTG's stance toward the artist was quite clear, but maybe something has changed recently. Isn't the running for the dumbest thing I've heard today? What do you mean MTG's stance? There's not like one unified global opinions of Magic. I'm playing the Guru lands because I like the art. They're my favorite, like one of my favorite basic land printings. I don't get it. I thought we had collectively agreed on how we were going to do that. So, I'm afraid that I've broken it. Have I played any modern since the banning? Yeah, I've played a decent amount. Not having Yorian to contend with is just a good quality of life increase. I would say in general, if you like an artist's work, you don't necessarily have to go too far into examining every interaction they've ever had. I don't know. Take an extra turn after this one. Trans rights are human rights? I completely agree. I don't believe that me playing a Guru Island takes away from that in any way at all. So, I'm capable of having more than one thought in my head at once. Against Spirits, I want Rending Volley and a Braid. And I guess, Sweltering Suns is less good than you think in general. Oh yeah, I guess I should have played it Lofty. No, that's actually a great point. This is just kind of expensive in sorcery speed, but I think it's okay. I think iteration... Basically, like, the whole iteration trespass thing is a lot harder to set up. I'm actually wondering if I want any iterations. I think... Because the thing is, pieces of the puzzle is not easy to resolve either. Against, like, Mausoleum Wanderer. I don't really want Young Pyromancer, so I'm not going to outrace them. I think I might put in Crackling Drake. Take out those two, and then... What's the... Oh, then Dispute. Why am I not playing Dispute, of course? And then I'll take out a piece of the puzzle as well. All right. Anger versus Sweltering Suns. Yeah, I don't really know why this particular version played Sweltering Suns. I just kind of found a list over Anger. Oh, I guess that's the answer. There we go. Boom. That was game one, yes. Are they printing Toronto Standard? Not as far as I know. What sort of experiences lead players to be good at constructing sideboards and sideboarding? I mean, in some ways, just playing a lot and having a lot of experience, like playing at high-level tournaments, gives you a good sense of that. In terms of constructing sideboards, most people who are, like, most players with lots of good tournament results aren't particularly great at constructing sideboards, but they find people who are and play their decks. Like, you know, I think I'm fairly good at tuning a deck. Like, if I play a deck for a bunch, I have a good sense of like some of the things to take in and take out. But like, I attribute a lot of my success on the Pro Tour to having the good sense to, you know, found and organize a team with great teammates, including people like, you know, Raptor and Kibler, who built really good decks, and in the case of Kibler, really good sideboards. He really just nailed the metagame in a lot of events, especially like small field events where he knew what his teammates were playing. But in general, I think it's hard to be good at those things, and those are two different things. Constructing a sideboard and using it are very different things. This hand's a little sketch, but I think it's okay to keep this on the draw. But as evidence, I did. But one of the cool things that I miss about Magic is getting really deep into testing matchups where you really figure out how the matchup works. And once you do that, you have a pretty good idea of how to sideboard, or at least the kind of cards that would be good in your sideboard. I guess I'll actually keep considering my on the top here. I think that's okay. Oh, baby. You look at that. Never been happier to see a Steam Vince. That's not true. When I played the PT, I don't know if Andrew Ellenbogen's to Hill, the PT where I lost to him in the finals, actually, I had some good Steam Vince top decks in that tournament. Yeah, I miss GPs and PTs too. Rip, Ripperoni. I guess rest in peace is legal, as it turns out. Put Mystical Dispute into my graveyard. No, I don't think I will. Let's do this. Shred some ledgers. Discard a treasure cruise. Put it in the graveyard. I was kind of hoping to draw a land. I guess that's a land indeed. Which GP was that, Sims, that we played? Am I going to the new PT? I'm not going to the regional championship, or at least I don't plan to, but I am going to go to the, I do plan on going to the PT. Oh yeah, that was the gifts PT. What to do? Did I know KubeCon was going on this weekend? I did not. I don't really know what that is. I think I'm just going to start by doing this. Let's get a fight started, because I want to trigger my Ledger Shredder. I feel like there's a pretty good chance they're going to play a see a guard approach? Target creature. Okay. Hey, Molda 5. Welcome back with the 67 months. I mean, I guess I don't like it, but I guess I'll do it. That was gross. Spell Pierce. Oh, I'm getting Ledger Shredders from both directions, sure. Let's just discard this Phoenix. Oh, I pressed OK too many times. Oh, actually, no, this is fine. Because I can just Mystical Dispute this. You see the guard approach now. Ooh, I kind of like Thing in the Ice, so I'm actually going to discard Consider. I'm going to dispute this because I still want to kill their thing. They have two cards in hand and I have a 4/6. It's not clear they have a really good answer to that thing. Yep, Sims, that GP was the Mystical Teachings GP. See, that was one where me, Chian, Paulo, and Webb stayed at Webb's house for like a week testing for a GP, which, you know, test for GPs as often after that. But and we tested the Teachings mirror till we found the line of play Teferi, Teachings for Teferi, play Teferi, flashback Teachings, get Detritivore. You'll probably have to look that one up if you're most Magic players. And then use Detritivore to win the mirror. All right, I'll let them play their Spellqueller, I guess. Geistlight Snare, huh? Okay, that's a lot less bad than Spellqueller. But we went super deep. We found a specific thing, and that was great. Me, Paulo, and Chian all made top 8 of the GP, so I think we had a good strategy. I mean, and they would have played Spellqueller if they had it. Also, it looks like they sided in. I'm not saying they're wrong to sideboard the way they did, but this is a lot of reactive cards they have in their deck now. And, I don't know. Ooh, that was gross. Okay. Not really what I want in the Spell Pierce world, but that's all right. Who won the GP? The person attacking with a 4-6 Ledger Shredder did. Yeah. Played a good friend of mine, John Stocks, in the finals, actually. Playing a homebrew. This is back when you could win with homebrews too. Pretty nice. Rattle Chions? Okay. I'm gonna win this race as it stands. It is possible that if they draw two creatures in a row and I draw two bricks in a row, then they hit me down to 8. Yeah. Oh, they're gonna draw with Spectral Sailor, hope to no. Oh, come on. They're supposed to leave this untapped in case they draw a land. So it's a big game. One land and I can animate Hall of the Storm Giant, so honestly, land is fine. I'm probably going to draw the last Treasure Cruise here. Oh no, this is the last Treasure Cruise. I'm probably going to draw the Temporal Trespass here. Do you answer the question in the title, whether is Pioneer the best format? Well, I'm not going to 5-0 this league, so I guess we kind of have answered that. I mean, Spectral Sailor is pretty bad for me. Like, they can... Granted, if I draw a land now, they're just double chumping is a lot different, but if they're just every turn drawing a card and drawing a chump blocker, it is a big game. Well, again, land would be really good here. Not tap land, please. Oh, baby. There we go. Deck the halls, or as I said last stream and now every time I play this, the halls decking you. Now they have to block Hall, go to 4. Now they're 2 lethal threats. 2 lethal threats is a little harder for them to keep up with Spectral Sailor. Especially since they're not really attacking me for damage here. And given that they have... You see a guard approach and Geistlight Snare and a bunch of other stuff. Like they can't have that many ways to deal with this in play. Like, I guess they can chump with the 2 Mutavolts this turn. I am probably not casting another spell this game. Do I like the new regional PT system? TBD. Like, I need to see what a Pro Tour feels like. And we also haven't had a single regionals yet. If regionals is cool and the Pro Tour is cool, the system I think's pretty solid. If regionals isn't cool but the Pro Tour is cool, kind of lukewarm. If the Pro Tour isn't cool, then yeah, that sucks, you know. So now they double chump. I mean, yes, we can cast Treasure Trues, but casting 6 mana 7/7 seems better than casting Treasure Cruise. Well, Pugaloo, there's a lot of different regional coordinators, so I don't know that that's true of other countries or whatever. Yep, I agree, David. If regionals is weak, the system has got a certain, it's got a flaw. Have they given Hall of Famers back their invites yet? Not exactly. Kind of. Not in this. Basically, as a Hall of Famer, I get an invite to one pro tour, so that's like the final step, and one regional a year. And then, well, in the same one. You can play the regionals, then play the pro tour. And then, if I do badly there, then I'm out of Hall of Fame invites. But I don't think that it's... I don't view that as a complete like betrayal of, you know, the Hall of Fame benefit. I think that's fine. If you get to start off the season knowing you're going to be queued for one PT, and then you had Lethal Abrade the Flyer. Yeah, I guess though, if they had some kind of counterspell or something, that would have been bad. But knowing that you're qualified for one cycle at the start is a pretty big advantage. If you can't convert on that and you tried, then so be it. You can play some of the regional championships and whatever. But I think I would have felt like they like let us down, you know, if there was no invites. But having one invite a year to a pro tour, I think is reasonable. I guess I don't want to cast Fire Impulse yet. The reason is, if I cast it now and then they play Spellqueller, that is unfortunate. Can you do last PT of Season 1, first PT of Season 2? You could, yeah. I have an invite to this first Pro Tour because of my finish at the last online Pro Tour to set championship. So I'm going to play at this one, see how it goes. If I do poorly, use my PT invite on the second, or Hall of Fame invite on the second one. If I do bad on both and can't queue for the third, then I just had a bad year and don't deserve to play the third. Do I miss Vintage? Yeah, I mean, I still play it from time to time, but yeah, Vintage is fun. How many Hall of Fame players actively play besides me? A pretty good amount. Nassif, Reed, Levy, all play a ton. All right. This was a grind. Never attacked with Hall of Stormlines this many turns in a row. Paulo, for sure. I'm sure there are other folks. How's Huey doing? Yeah. Crushing it at Wizards, no doubt. Huey likes his job. I mean, he gets to work on Magic, which is really cool. And he has a cool job, like getting to work on organized play. And I know he likes his team, so. All right, 3-1. Not bad. Druin with the 40 months. Welcome back. Thanks for hanging out. Kai still plays as well. Vintage Super League. I do miss that one, yeah. Let's close this out strong. Do you know who's on his team? Is that public information? I mean, it's an internal team at Wizards. I don't know. My guess is it's not. They don't usually release their org charts to the public. And I also think it probably wouldn't mean anything to most people. It's just a bunch of names of folks, you know. Will I go to Vegas on MTG 30? No, I'm not going to MTG 30. One of my good friends here, Josh Utterleighton, Raptero, speaking of Hall of Famers, speaking of watched Hall of Famers, has having a wedding party that Saturday, so I'm going to that. Later, Sims. Have a good one, dude. Not mulliganing a hand of three cantrips, obviously. This is a swamp. I hate that land. Oh, we'll put Axe into the graveyard. Yes, indeed. Brick. And... I don't like lands that look like other lands. This looks like a mountain. It's got a big red thing in the middle. Hey, thanks for the raid. SBM MTG Dev. Let's just pass here. Am I ready to start my career as a Marvel Snap Pro? I've been snapping. It's fun. Yeah, I don't like the Midnight Hunt Full Arts either. For the same reason. Thing in the Ice against Red Black, probably mid-range. No, I don't think that's what I want. Yeah, I guess I'll kind of reluctantly put Steam Vents on top. I'll be mad if I draw another land here. Basically, because putting it on top means Pieces of the Puzzle is a good draw, and Pieces of the Puzzle is a really important card in this matchup. And when I have this kind of hand, I'm gonna play a creature. Yeah, it's a Graveyard Trespasser. Okay, well, this is actually going to be fine because it's actually gonna, the ward ability is actually going to be good for me because now I'm going to play this and discard a Phoenix. And hopefully draw something. Ooh, consider. Nice. I'll put that in my graveyard, yes. Ooh. Oh, okay, so let's go Nug You. Treasure Cruise. Do have to remove the iteration, but getting a Phoenix out of the deal, pretty good. Boom. When I'm playing an Overwatch 2 stream, yeah, I've never played Overwatch, and at this point I won't play Overwatch 2, I don't think. Fable of the Mirror Breaker. Great card, but not really going to do it here. So the question is kind of funny. Do I want to chart a course here? I actually think I'm going to Pieces of the Puzzle. Let's play this as an island. Let's cast Pieces of the Puzzle. Ooh, Pieces of the Puzzle plus Opt. Don't mind if I do. Then attack with the Arclight Phoenix. I am going to want to Fiery Impulse the Goblin Shaman. Okay, now I have a pretty good, a fully stocked graveyard. Could use another Arclight Phoenix at some point here. Is it more fun to play to play-by-play PTs or go through the grind? Oh, you're asking if it's more fun to do coverage or play in a PT? Way more fun to play in a PT. It's not particularly close. Ooh, they're going to Graveyard Trespasser me. Look at the Mondo combo. My Arclight Phoenix is dead. It's not. I'm being a little sarcastic because it doesn't matter too much. Let's go Opt-Reno. Put that on the bottom. I'm going to draw a lot of cards this turn, I think. So, don't care too much. Yeah, I think I'm just going to double cruise here. I've got all these spell pierces that aren't really doing much for me. And I guess I'll play... There's a chance, I think, that I do end up. This is... Here's a battlefield or attacks. The problem is I can't do it all. So what I am going to do is do this. Discarding a spell pierce. So now it has three... No, it has three sorceries in the graveyard. But I can't do that and discard a Phoenix, unfortunately. No, I still can't discard multiple cards to the thing. So that's still not true. I discarded the Phoenix to hand. I had to discard. Okay, so let's walk through this. I cast Fiery Impulse, discarding Spell Pierce as the third spell to make this kill the Trespasser. If I did that, I couldn't then discard Phoenix. So, I think I'm going to play this. Spell Mastery is only two. I stand corrected. Mea culpa. I thought it was three. No, you had a better play, for sure. Let's go this, discard Phoenix, chart a course, discard Phoenix, kill the reflection because that's a little bit more dangerous. And next turn I think I'm going to want to temporal Pieces of the Puzzle into Trespass or something, I don't know, we'll see. Not too worried about their Blood Tithe Harvester here. I have three Phoenixes. I didn't really want to eat two, a couple of them to make my treasure cruise work here. No, Spell Mastery is not a mechanic. I assumed it was three, because that's... Why did I assume it was three? Is there something else that's three? I just assumed it was for some reason. Fatal Push. Okay. Three is a much more common number for that sort of thing. But, all right, so then I'm going to play. Maybe because of the Phoenix, sure. I still think I'm fine here, but I need to draw. Lightning Axe would be pretty good, actually. Let's see, six mana. I think I'm just going to have to cruise here. God, I really... Hold on. I'm going to cast Piece of the Puzzle. I basically don't want to exile... or not, I need to delve the max amount. I could hit my last Phoenix here, too. I think I'm going to take Consider and Opt into hand here. I haven't played a land yet. Let's cast Consider. So I draw an untapped blue source. I could actually Temporal Trespass here as my third spell. One Phoenix. Yeah, that's why I said my last Phoenix, right? Oh, there are two Phoenixes in exile already? Well, either case, these Phoenixes are coming back now. Now I kind of wish I kept the Temporal Trespass, but I guess... I don't know, that's kind of hard. Okay. Whack. They go to 9. Put them to 3 here. Wait, do I have another iteration in my deck? No. I was thinking I could Spike Field Hazard them down, but I couldn't quite do that. I have 14 cards left, so I'm not going to get decked, really. Famous last words. Let's cast Pieces of the Puzzle, because I do want to find a way to kill this graveyard. I'm going to take all these axes, but I guess I don't even really need to kill the Graveyard Trespasser that badly. Removal spell. I guess I will spell pierce that, actually. Pretty good value there. And guess I'll just discard my hand to kill Graveyard Trespasser. Well, I mean, at that point, I might as well cast Treasure Cruise first, right? Go to 6 cards left. Sure. Why not? Don't think I need to play. They have no cards in hand? Uh-oh. Let's just do this. Discarding this. Discarding this. Kill the Blood Tithe Harvester 2. Well, actually, that's a sorcery speed. Let's just play this and pass. If they sorcery speed want to kill my Arclight Phoenix, that's fine with me. Cause I have 3 spells in hand. I can just bring it back. Wow, just battling down to 6. Do I want to kill the Blood Tithe Harvester? 1 card, 6 damage. I don't think I need to do anything here. Could be wrong. Okay. New cube, sweet. What is the new cube? I don't like thinking the ice against decks that have good removal, because like you just invest a bunch of time trying to make it work and then gets blown up. It doesn't seem great to me. It's called Land Cube. Cartographia Cube. What is that? Ether Gas, Mystical Spew. Unlicensed Hearse. Messes with their Kroxa. That or Sweltering Suns. I think I'd rather just have Sweltering Suns. Don't think I want Gust. It gets Fable, Bone Crusher, kinda. Oh, there was just two Bone Crushers, is why. One was shown in the Exile Zone. Oh, nice. Let me take a look at this Cartographia Cube. I'm off it, I guess. Iteration is okay for value. I don't really like iteration against people who are like thought-seizing you and stuff. Oh, our new place is great. Tenacious Underdog. All right. Not like I love doing this, but I think it's better than, I don't know what I do, not killer two drop. Ooh, that can be a way to, if I keep this in hand and they blitz it, it does kill it for forever. Mm-hmm. Ooh, very nice. Play Opt and get rid of this Lightning Axe. Thank you very much. Oh, I will put another Shredderino on top for sure. Okay, that's not the end of the world. I don't really have too much that I care about in there. A cantrip would be kind of nice this turn. I could Spikefield Hazard to do a bunch of looting. That seems kind of weak. I probably won't do that. We'll see what I draw, I suppose. What is my best draw here? Fiery Impulse, maybe? All right, well, I'm going to play another Shredder. I don't have Temporal Trespass in my deck, so I think I'm just going to play Lava Glide and attack for two. I don't know. At some point, maybe I'll play this, but I don't really care too much about them getting a Graveyard Trespasser. Casting this to, like, loot twice didn't seem very good, and Hall of Storm Giants also makes me want to hit my land drops, so, like, I don't know. Oh my god, Shield Root's gonna be horrible for me. Now I wish I had that Lightning Axe. Wow. Okay, I mean, Crackling Drake is at least good. Now I think I'm in a bit of trouble. Attack with Graveyard Trespasser, huh? Could just block with the Crackling Drake. Then I go to 7, Shieldred in play. Could also block Shieldred and then Spikefield Hazard it. It's a 4 and this is a 4. I guess I'm probably rather off doing this, even though obviously not too happy about it either way. I just think when I'm at 7, beating a shield druid seems pretty hard. Oh. Sure. Okay. This is pretty good with shield druid in play. Oh, nice. Treasure cruise. All right. I don't think I can afford to put in Disdainful Stroke against just Shieldred, so I guess I'm on the keep Lightning Axe in hand plan, sure. Seems reasonable enough to me. I'm gonna lead on River Glide because if I only had one cantrip, I might save them to cast after Ledger Shredder, but I feel like my opponent, most likely enough to Thoughtseize me, probably take the Shredder, and then I'm just gonna wanna tear through these cantrips. Mm-hmm. Oh yes, put that in the graveyard, please. Supposed to put that one in the graveyard. Oh. Young Peasy, all right. Just do this. Yes, they might kill it, but at least their turn two is spent killing it and not playing a two drop or something. Oh, that's true. I could have cast the cruise, looted off the things. That's not what I was hoping to see. All right. let's go nuts with opts. Is there anything that would cause me to want to opt here? I guess if I opt in here and to consider... I'm going to put this on top, actually. If I opted in to consider and then cast consider and discard and mill the Phoenix, that would be good. But... kind of hoping... That's not what I was hoping this was. Jeez. Oh... I should have also actually not cast that in response. Alright. Yeah, I'm basically dead here. I should have had one to opt in the graveyard, but... I was trying to get more information before discarding, which is a pretty normal thing. I guess I'll just keep Chandra on top. If I draw a land, it's a card that can help me come back. That go blank was brutal, though. We were about to treasure cruise. Is this my standard deck? Well, this is the deck I've been playing. I don't know. Dang, if I had put Chandra on the bottom and then drawn Ledger Shredder instead, that would have worked out a lot better. I think we're going to take an L here. Hey, Destructo. Welcome back with the 3-month Arisa Marino. Can't really imagine winning this game. Yeah, their hand was the ideal red-black hand, I guess. Let's go Chandra, I guess. Goblin Shaman. I mean, they even have these lands to activate. Yeah, no, we're dead here. Good beats. Go Blank got us pretty good. Yeah, this deck's pretty good. I didn't love the sideboard, I guess. Yeah, it was okay. I'm not sure about Young Pyromancer. The problem I have with Young Pyromancer is... the cards that kill Ledger Shredder basically universally kill Young Pyromancer, I guess, Rending Volley aside. So, siding in a card when they're already leaving in the removal for Ledger Shredder, kind of underwhelming. And in this case, it actually let them cast Stomp off Bone Crusher, which doesn't even have any targets in this deck, I mean, killing Phoenix aside. So, but the whole game plan of just tearing through your deck, casting Cruise, Trespass, and bring back Phoenix is pretty sweet, so... thanks for watching. This deck's pretty good. It's one of the better Pioneer decks for sure. I'm not going to say it's better than Red Black or Mono Green, but it is strong. Remember to check out ChannelFireball.com for all the articles you need. This video was brought to you by Ultimate Guard, sponsor of Team CFB. And check out TCG Player for any card you need. Thanks for watching. See you next time.